두 달 전 허리케인이 미국 남부 지역을 덮치면서 38명이 숨졌습니다. 미국과 유럽의 슈퍼컴퓨터는 허리케인이 멕시코에 상륙할 걸로 예측했지만 이런 예보와 달리 허리케인은 방향을 북쪽으로 틀었습니다. 이 진로를 정확히 맞힌 건 구글에서 개발한 AI 기상 예측 모델 그래프캐스트였습니다. 수천억 원에 달하는 슈퍼컴퓨터보다 AI 기상 예측 모델이 어떻게 더 정확할 수 있었을까? SBS는 구글의 AI 개발 조직 딥마인드에서 2021년부터 AI 기상 예측 모델을 개발한 연구과학자 레미램을 화상으로 인터뷰했습니다.
There's been like several decades of research in weather forecasting, but it's becoming increasingly difficult to make advances in that field. And we're also in a world that is getting warmer, and for which making accurate weather prediction is really important. And so we really needed a breakthrough in weather forecasting. So that's why in 2021 at Google DeepMind we started working on weather forecasting. Global medium range, and that's why we built GraphCast.
레미램은 전통적인 기상 예측 방식과 그래프캐스트의 차이를 이렇게 설명했습니다.
Traditional approaches work by solving complex physical equations, and so those physical equations they are very good, but they don't capture everything that happens in the world, and so they're imperfect. And even if they were perfect, to solve them, they're so complex, we need supercomputer to approximately solve them. So that means that those traditional approaches, essentially, there's error accumulating over time. The GraphCast and AI weather methods, basically, work very differently. They don't solve any physical equations. They work by learning directly from data. So they learn purely from historical weather data. And because they can learn from those observation data, basically, where we can see really what happened, they can make better prediction over time. And outperform the traditional approaches.
그래프캐스트는 전 세계에서 가장 정확한 기상 데이터를 보유한 유럽 중기 예보 센터의 40년치 기상 데이터를 학습해 온도, 습도, 풍속, 풍향, 예상 강우량 등의 예측 결과를 3차원 그래픽 데이터로 내놓습니다. 레미램이 꼽은 AI 기상 예측 모델의 장점은 세 가지입니다.
The one that people tend to remember the most is that it's really really fast to make a prediction. So you train the model and once the model is trained, you can make a 10-day forecast in less than 1 minute on a computer chip of basically this size. I can hold it in my hand. It's very small. While traditional approaches, they would take typically an hour on a supercomputer the size of a bus. So now you go from an hour to 1 minute, and you go from like needing a supercomputer to basically like a computer chip you can use on the cloud. So it's really, really cheap now to make a weather forecast prediction. So that's the first thing. It's really fast. The second is that the prediction actually more accurate. So that's what we showed. And by learning directly from that really good data set, we can make better predictions. So it's not only faster, it's better. So that's the second advantage.
또 AI 모델의 학습과 추론이 구글 클라우드 서비스에 온라인으로 접속해 이루어지기 때문에 데이터 공유와 연구 접근성 측면에서도 장점이 있습니다. 하지만 아직 한계도 명확합니다. 그래프캐스트는 12시간 이후부터 열흘 뒤의 날씨 같은 단기 기상 예측은 잘하지만 몇 개월 뒤인 장기 예측은 전통 예측 방식보다 뒤떨어진다는 평가를 받습니다.
I think the reason is not entirely clear, but my guess would be that at short-term prediction, basically those models, they don't have time to accumulate a lot of error. So if I'm making prediction for the next hours, basically if my model is a little bit wrong, it won't have time for the error to add up to something not useful. And so you can be very good in that range. When you're going to like several years, you can see that the small error that you make at every step of your prediction can accumulate. And so, they can lead to bad prediction over time. And the traditional approaches, and that's the beauty of the equations, is that those equations capture certain property of the weather that we believe should happen. For instance, energy should be conserved, mass should be conserved. And right now for climate prediction, for instance, like very, very long-term prediction, we believe that like conserving those quantities is very important for the prediction to be stable and kind of accurate. So maybe that's like a reason for which like right now, I would say that all the AI models are really focused on like very short-term.
레미램은 장기적으로는 물리 법칙을 완벽히 이해하는 AI 모델 개발이 목표라며 개발 초기엔 구글의 AI 반도체 TPU V4 32개를 3주간 학습시켜야 했다면 이제는 일주일 만에 완료하고 추론 단계인 기상 예측은 단 한 개의 TPU 칩만으로도 가능하다고 설명했습니다. 슈퍼컴퓨터의 기상 예측 결과를 인간 예보관이 종합해 해석하는 기존 방식을 AI가 완전히 대체할 수 있을까?
What I believe is that, There's always a human in the loop. There's always a human making kind of the call about whether or not there's like an emergency or not. And what has happened over the past decades is that they've had like those very good tools, those traditional weather models that they've been able to use, but they're still in the loop, right? They're still making the decision. They're still making the calls. And what we're seeing with AI weather model is that now they have a new tool they can use. They have just another way of making the computation to inform their decision. So I think they should be pretty happy to have a new, you know, a new tool that they can use and they can inform the way they do their job. But I don't expect them to, you know, I think there's always going to be a human in the loop.
지구 온난화로 날씨 예측이 갈수록 어려워지는 가운데 레미램은 아직 활용하지 못하고 있는 기상 데이터가 무수히 많다며 더 많은 데이터를 학습해 날씨 예측 자체의 불확실성까지 예측하는 것이 다음 시대를 여는 열쇠가 될 것이라고 말했습니다.
And so I think like really like we're really in, like in a phase where we're really trying to demonstrate that this is a viable technology and there's going to be application for that. Right now this is not the focus of our research team. But there's definitely many, many applications, and you know, like it's such what we call a core root node problem that it, once you solve that, you kind of unlock a lot of applications, and it has a lot of value for everyone in the world.
SBS 홍유재입니다.